WA's billion-dollar timber industry says it's been blindsided by a state government plan to cease native forest logging within 2 years. The move is partly guided by the need to combat climate change, but will leave hundreds of families without work.
They are the giants of the southwest, and in less than 2 years, native forests like this will be protected from logging.
It's 400,000 hectares of forest that would have been logged that will now be saved.
This is a really important tool in our toolkit for fighting climate change.
But today's state government announcement has sent shockwaves through the billion-dollar forestry industry.
I'm just so heartbroken. They've taken such a huge decision and blindsided an industry without even talking to us.
More than 2,000 jobs, some which have spanned over five generations, set to be lost.
I mean, there's some towns like Nanup, for example, or Greenbushes, where the vast majority of the population there are employed by the local mill. The impact will be massive.
The news hit hard for timber towns like Manjimup today. The future of businesses like Parkside Timber is now up in the air. It employs 160 locals and has spent more than $50 million on upgrades in recent years.
But it's virtually ripped the heart out of our district. We're just really suffering.
Labor does plan to spend $50 million of tomorrow's state budget to help employees and businesses transition out of the industry, and $350 million will be allocated to build new pine plantations over the next 10 years, creating 160 jobs.
We're very sympathetic to families and businesses that will be impacted upon by this decision.
The industry says, unlike some overseas practices, logging in WA is sustainable. It says the appetite for hardwood hasn't decreased, and it's concerned if wood has to be imported, it could do more harm for the environment than good.
You just don't go and cut the legs out of a whole community.
Anne-Marie Leonard for 10 News First.